What's up, everybody? Thank you for tuning in to this edition of Dsire to Nspire with Gilly B. And of course, this is yours truly, Gilly B. And on today's show, we're going to talk about speaking up. But of course, before that, you know how we always do it. It is a Gilly B's funny moment in history. All right, so this one, man, let me tell y'all, how many times this has happened to me? You know, you got that person, you know, you at this event, you know, there's so many people around, and you might see somebody have on a particular thing, or somebody might be doing a particular thing, and you whisper to somebody next to you, and you be like, yo, look what he got on, look what she got on, right? And you say, but don't look, I want them to know that we talk about it, right? And what they do? They turn around and look, and then the person, I don't know how this always happened, the person looking right at me, because I'm the one that leaned over and whispered. I'm like, dog, what I told you not to turn around. I'm like, man, you can't follow directions. How many times that done happened to y'all? I know I'm not the only one. And you know what I'm saying? And sometimes I'm not the one saying it. Somebody else saying it to me, I don't turn around. But as soon as I say something, oh, nah, they got to turn around and look. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, you know what? Let me stop doing that, because I was the one getting caught. You know what I'm saying? I can follow directions. Some people can't follow direction, man. Y'all better cut that out. Y'all know, you know what I'm talking about. But y'all, again, y'all know how I do it there. Y'all know how I do it. So today, I'm going to change it up a little bit on us. Y'all, we're going to do a spoken word today. We're going to do a spoken word. This is my first time doing a spoken word for you all, for my audience. So this is called a silent voice. And just kind of give you a little background information about the silent voice. I wrote this, I think, about 3 years ago, maybe. I wrote this, I'm from Kane Street, but I was staying in Lake City at the time, and they had this, kind of showcase, a spoken word showcase, and I wrote this, and, it was basically centered around Lake City, South Carolina. So you'll hear some things at the end that talks about Lake City. So I just want to kind of prep y'all with that. You'll be like, whoa, what LC? What is that? So that's LC is Lake City. All right. So this is about, this is during Black History Month that this was done. So it basically speaks about, in reference to African American history, Black American history, things like that. All right. So just listen to the lines. I mean, it just when I was writing this, I was just like, man, is this really like, wow, this stuff coming together kind of quick, you know? This is my first actually spoken word, y'all. So, you know, don't be in judgment now. but enjoy it though. This is my first one, but I was like, man, it inspired me to write more because the way it would flow. So hopefully it'll flow just as well today as it did when I actually wrote it the first time. So again, it's called The Silent Voice. So what's in a voice? Is it the formation of the vocal cords inherited from past generations, which imitates in mockery, screams in panic, yells in frustration and anger, and whispers in fear? Yes. Is it the pitch for someone to sing soprano, alto, tenor, or bass? Yes. Is it the inconsistent volume of loudness and softness, or even silence, which projects a powerful message that so boldly speaks for us? Yes. But you say, lift my voice, right? What you mean, lift my voice? Do you really think I have a voice? See, for me, there is no choice in whether I lift my voice, because it has been so long since I spoke out that I don't know the sound of my own voice. The true fact is that no one wants to listen to this little black boy who they toy and play with as they plot to steal my joy. The joy I bring when coming to work, speaking to everyone with a big smile, but when turning their backs, putting me on trial. Scheming how to take me down and slander my name as they seek to prosecute me as a castaway into education exile. However, they fail to realize in their pathetic little brains that are twisted in a knot with dripping haterade that I'm no longer a boy but now a grown man. Yes, I can, because this brother takes command. Say what you will and do what you may, but believe there is coming a day when you will pay for treating me this way. So don't be fooled by what you see, because man looks at the outer appearance, but God looks at the heart, and my heart is pure with the cure for your hateful and spiteful ways. See, I understand speaking with sound verbally expresses what is deeply rooted in our hearts, while silence keeps our deep truths hidden in the shadows of congestive heart failure. So always be aware of those who crouch behind the door of silence and severe, sever themselves into isolation, for we are clueless of the beats of their blanketed hearts or their enlarged thoughts, leading to a brain aneurysm, causing them to bleed out the true issues of their hearts. So what is the purpose of having a voice with so much power but yet is not being heard? Are you content with letting your voice die inside of you like a stillborn baby inside its mother's womb? God created us all different in our own unique way. Therefore, each of us have power in what we say. Will you choose your voice to be heard or stand by and listen to things that are so absurd? But no, just as there is life and death in the power of the tongue, there is power in your lungs to sing songs that once from African Americans' lips so loudly sung. So what has happened to our unified black voice singing, "We shall overcome and rejoice because we made the choice to raise only one voice"? But the truth is, we have silenced our voice without making the choice to unite in exposing the dark deeds to the light of those who are fake snakes and all the other traits, turning everything upside down with a frown, all by using others without even making a sound. How can this be that we can't see what is the missing key? Once in the history of black America, we valued education like how kids today value Jordans, iPhones, Facebook, Snapchat, texting, video games, and any other electronic distractions that short circuits their brains from learning and thinking for themselves. The voice of education has been silenced by parents, the community, and churches, so we retreat in defeat because leaders can't take the heat for getting offbeat with concerns of academics, behavior, discipline, and violence, not realizing many of the students barely master third grade skills. Make sense of that. Some are quick to talk about people not helping and supporting, but when people do, where are you? You shy? Yeah, I'm putting you on blast since you fronting like you really care about our children when really you could care less. Answer this. Never mind, because in our public schools, your children are probably won't find. LOL at that. The rich keeps getting richer and the poor keeps getting poorer, so how can things change in public education but to keep going lower and lower? Why? Because many of our students deal with the stress of home and taking tests in which many times they don't give their best and shrugging their shoulders like the heck with the rest. So what up, LC? Will you stay true to what you once knew or stand in silence like you don't even have a clue? It's time for us to finally find the true voice of unity. Churches, focus on outreach to save the lost, no matter the cost. And schools, focus on educating and obtaining a better rating that will have other districts really hating. And finally, community, love your neighbor as yourself is God's command, and we should always lend a helping hand and march in sync like the Lake City High School marching band. So will you continue to allow laryngitis paralyze our community? Or will you be set free from the first person me to become we and speak in unity, because who the Son sets free is free indeed? When I wrote that, y'all, I mean, it's just like, wow. It's just like, I was amazed because I'm like, this is my first time writing one. I was like, man, this thing was flowing. But the thing about it is when they had this showcase, I could not remember it. I could not remember it. And I was like, I felt so ashamed. But I knew what I wrote, it was speak to people. So sometimes you'll go to do things, you think you have it together, you'll write it, or you'll write the music, you'll write the words, whatever it is. And you think you have it together, and sometimes things don't come out as you expect them to come out. But I never gave up on knowing that my message, there's a message in what I was saying. And it's truth. A lot of people don't like truth, but that's truth, y'all. And so I just want to point you to a few scriptures here that I wrote down about speaking up. Proverbs 31:8 says, "Speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves, for the rights of all who are destitute." Y'all, we have to be advocates. We have to be advocates for our children, especially. There are some, in this time of COVID-19 right now, there are children who are at home, who are going through situations that we could only dream unimaginable. They are going through situations with parents who don't want them homes, parents who don't want them, parents who could care less about their well-being. Y'all, we have to be advocates for these children. We may not know, or some of us may know. What are we doing to advocate for them? What are we doing to advocate for our children? What are we doing to advocate for our older people, our elderly people? We have to advocate. We have to speak up, y'all. Some people will not be able to speak up. Some people can't speak up. But for those who have that ability, speak up for people. Speak up for them. Represent for them. That's one. And another one is 1 John 1 chapter First John chapter 1, verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he, talking about God, is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. So this is talking about, okay, we're talking about speaking up. I'm not saying go out and tell your sins to everybody, all right? Sometimes people can see them without you even saying anything. But the fact of the matter is, God wants you to talk with him. He knows what you're doing. God knows everything. He sees everything. So it's a question to him. It might be a question to everybody else around you, but it's not a question what you're doing when it comes to God. God knows everything. Remember, he's the one that created us. So he knows. So what I'm saying today is, if you have been struggling with the sin that you're doing, no matter what the sin is, it doesn't matter. There's no big sin, little sin. Sin is sin. God didn't say, okay, this is 1% sin, this is 100% sin. No. Every sin is a sin. So if you know, as you read the word of God, or the word of the Lord, some people say, if you read that, you'll begin to learn what is sin and what is not sin. All right? Not from what people say, because people will mislead you and make you think that something is a sin and it's not a sin, and they'll tell you something is not a sin and it might be a sin. So the thing is, read the word and meditate on the word for yourself. Learn what sin actually is. Learn what sin is and begin to confess that to God. God wants to hear your voice. God wants to hear you. He wants us to be advocates for others, but he also wants to be advocate for ourselves when it comes to our lives. He wants us to live pure and righteously before him and holy. So that's another verse. And the last one I have here is James 1:19. Know this, my beloved brothers, let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger. In some situations, we have to learn that we must listen first. Sometimes we can speak too quick and we can be very embarrassed in front of people because we didn't take a moment to hear the full length of what somebody has to say. So I wanted to say that because a lot of times, especially in the time that we live now, people are so defensive. My wife told me I was defensive, all right? So she's talking, and before she can finish, I'm already jumping on her like, you know, whatever. And she's like, can I finish? So I'm like, okay. So that's something I'm learning to do, all right? Because how I know that what she was about to say was gonna keep me from saying what I had to say. So we just need to make sure that we are slow to speak, we are quick to hear, because some people say God gave us two ears and one mouth. So that means we should do more hearing than we should do talking. So I wanna encourage you all with that, because like I said, this spoken word, this is my first one, and I'm excited about it. I'll be writing more and just, man, I'm just excited, y'all, because the message, there's so much message in it, and I didn't think I could do it. You know, I heard people talking about spoken word. Now, I might not be the one that be able to do it, like I say, in front of everybody without paper. Now, I'm not saying I could do that, but I got the paper right here. I'm reading off it, so, hey, I can do that. But the thing is, whatever is in you to do, don't be afraid. Just do it. Just do it. When I sat down and actually just went on and tried to do this and entered the showcase, even though I didn't do as I expected to do, but nevertheless, I wrote this and I felt good after I did it. If you got the ability, if you got the passion, just go forth and do it. Don't let it just sit there, all right? Don't let it just sit there. So I just want to pray over you. God, we thank you, Lord God, for teaching us when to listen and when to speak up, Lord God. There are situations, Lord God, that there are people that need advocates, God. Lord God, we ask, God, that you supply advocates, Lord God, for your people, God, who need them. We thank you, Lord God, for giving insight and wisdom, Lord God, to everyone who wants to be an advocate on behalf of others, God, that they may speak on their behalf, God, that they may act on their behalf, God. We thank you now, Lord God, for leading them to do so in Jesus' name. Amen. So as always, I want to always remind you to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and y'all know YouTube. Check me out on YouTube. Hit that like button. But more so, I want you to subscribe so other people can hear and then be inspired and encouraged as you are as you listen right now. And then when you search, make sure you search Dsire, the number 2, Nspire. And of course, when you search, make sure it says with Gilly B, because if you don't, then that's not me, yo. Hey, haha. So every Monday at 11:45 a.m., you can catch me here on WDRB Media Radio, where we're the voice of the community, and we have double the information and inspiration. See you next week.